Azure AI Studio allows you to evaluate single-turn or complex multi-turn conversations where you ground the generative AI model in your specific data. You can also evaluate general single-turn question answering scenarios where no context is used to ground your generative AI model. Automated measurement is useful for measuring at scale with increased coverage to provide more comprehensive results. It's also helpful for ongoing measurement to monitor for any regression as the system, usage, and mitigations evolve. We support two main methods for automated measurement of generative AI applications: traditional machine learning metrics and AI-assisted metrics. Let's assume that I've created a RAG chatbot which leverages a Contoso Camping Store product dataset to provide customers with product information. I'll complete an automated evaluation to validate whether the model generates the desired output. I'll first start by creating a new evaluation and selecting the scenario, which is a question and answer without context. Next, I'll configure the test data by adding my dataset that's formatted with a question, ground truth, and answer for each row of data. Now that my data is uploaded, I'll select my preferred metrics for evaluation. I'll select all the performance and quality metrics. Azure OpenAI is my connection, and my deployed model is GPT-4. As for the risk and safety metrics, I'll select all these as well and set the threshold to medium for calculating the defect rate. Just below, I've confirmed that the dataset is already mapped appropriately to the evaluation input. The final step is to review all my configurations and then click Submit to begin the automated evaluation. Now that the evaluation is complete, the metric dashboard appears with the evaluation results. Starting with the performance and quality metrics, the highest score possible for each metric is 5. The average score for coherence is great, given that it's the highest possible score. As for fluency, the score is good, but there's some room for improvement. And as for similarity, there's certainly some improvements that could be made. Switching to the risk and safety metrics, it appears that each row evaluated contains safe content. We can take a closer look at the results within the detailed metrics results section. I'll start by rearranging the columns to an order that's easier for me to analyze the results. Looking at the results, I can individually see how each answer was evaluated for the performance and quality metrics. The same applies to the risk and safety metrics as well. Not only can I see the severity level, but there's also an explanation which explains the reasoning. The intended audience and requirements of my chatbot influences the next steps that I could take to improve my results. For example, I may find it necessary to modify the system message or add a content filter to provide another layer of risk mitigation. After making any modifications, I could run another evaluation and compare the results against each other, leveraging my prior evaluation as a baseline. To get started with automated evaluation, visit ai.azure.com.